This fall, I bought a new plant. It's an orange mum, and it looks great outside my house. But the weather is already getting colder in New York, and if the temperature goes below freezing, my new plant will die. I gathered data on hourly temperatures in New York over the past several weeks. Using this time series data, I'm going to use the Lag Llama model, an open source foundation model, to predict the overnight low temperature and help me decide when I need to bring the plant indoors to keep it alive. First, we'll clone the open source GitHub repo. I'm using a notebook with an IBM WatsonX.ai Studio for this project, but you can use any environment to run this model. Next, we'll install the pre-trained model weights from the Hugging Face repo, where they're stored. We use the Hugging Face CLI to download the trained Lag Llama checkpoint. Now we have the weights for a pre-trained model that we can use in our zero-shot forecasting. We need to import libraries to work with Lag Llama. For this project, we'll use GlueOnTS, an open-source PyTorch-based library for working with time series data and forecasting models. Next, we need to load the dataset for our tutorial. You can find this dataset in the repo along with the notebook. This time series data contains hourly temperatures in New York for the months of October and November. The data was gathered from ACIS Web Services. I'm loading data from within my project in WatsonX.ai Studio, but this will differ depending on what environment you're using and where you're storing the data file. The data has some missing readings. We'll fill them in by interpolating between values, so there's no missing values in the time series. Here's what the data looks like. We can see the trend of colder weather throughout the fall. Now we're ready to make predictions. In traditional time series forecasting, with a model like ARIMA, we'd have to first train the model on this dataset. Lag Llama works differently. As a foundation model, it can create a forecast without pre-training, the same way that an LLM can output text without being pre-trained on a task. This works because Lag Llama is trained on large-scale time series datasets, like how LLMs are trained on a massive corpus of text data. The Lag Llama model uses a transformer architecture, based on the Llama model architecture. The model makes use of lag features, or previous readings from the time series, like traditional forecasting models, such as ARIMA. We need to specify some configuration settings for our model. The prediction length is how many time steps each prediction should contain. We'll predict the overnight temperatures, so 8 hours out. The context length sets the number of time points looking back into the past that the model should look for lagged correlations. We'll look back 1 week when making these overnight predictions. Now we'll create the forecaster. This step consists of two parts. First, we create a Lag Llama estimator, which uses all the parameters copied from the downloaded Lag Llama model. The second step is to create a Lag Llama predictor, using the create predictor method of the estimator. This allows us to pass a context length sized window of data to get the forecast from the predictor. Now we're ready to create our forecasts. We'll focus on days in late November because I know that's typically when the first frost of the season happens. We'll use the make evaluation predictions method from the GlueOnTS evaluation library to generate our forecasts. Now that we've generated our forecasts, we'll evaluate them against the ground truth data. We'll use an evaluator object, also from the GlueOnTS evaluation library. We'll generate several metrics that we can use to evaluate the accuracy of our forecasts, but we'll focus on mean absolute percentage error, or MAPE. Once we have the evaluations for each prediction, we can graph each prediction. Our chart shows each of our 6 zero-shot forecasts, shown in green, and the actual time series data, the blue line. For each forecast, we can see the mean forecast as the green line, the boundaries of the 50% prediction interval in dark green, and the boundaries of the 90% prediction interval in lighter green. These prediction intervals show us how certain our model is about the forecast at each step. This is an advantage of a probabilistic model. It will show us how certain it is at each step in the forecast. So what does this mean for my new plant? To be cautious, I think anytime the 50% prediction interval indicates a frost, I'll take the plant inside. By this measure, the Lag Llama model performs pretty well at predicting an overnight forecast. For example, in this first chart for November 24th, the model predicts within the 50% prediction interval that the overnight temperature will go below freezing. And it does. We can see that the blue line tracks fairly closely to the green predicted line. This is also reflected in our low MAPE for this day's predictions. For the date of November 28th, we see a less accurate forecast from the model. On this day, the overnight temperature drops to the coldest yet this season. For this prediction, we see the actual temperature ends up within the 90% prediction interval, but mostly misses the 50% prediction interval. But following my guideline to take the plant inside anytime the 50% prediction interval goes below freezing, I would have saved my plant on this day, so it's not bad performance overall from the model. Based on the results with my new outdoor plant, we can see that foundation models hold promise for time series forecasting. While we've seen a lot of applications for the use of generative AI and foundation models for LLMs, applying these approaches to time series forecasting is still a developing field.